Welcome. Thank you for joining us for our Nonfiction Book Buzz. I'm Stephen.
And I'm Cindy.
And we're going to be sharing some of the nonfiction books that we're adding to the library this fall. Cindy and myself, we are the two librarians that select adult nonfiction print materials for the library. So this is just going to be a sampling of some of the many, many books that we are ordering for this fall. We'd also love to hear your comments about what nonfiction book you're most looking forward to reading this fall, whether it's one that we're going to be including in this presentation or if it's something else. Please leave us a comment and let us know. We'd love to know what you're looking forward to reading. The first book that I'm going to talk about is Think Like a Monk by Jay Shetty. He is a social media superstar and host of the number one podcast On Purpose. In this book, he shares timeless wisdom he learned as a monk. This book promises to teach you how to overcome negativity, stop overthinking, use your fears to your advantage, how to learn from everyone you meet, and much more. And these practical steps can be used by anyone to achieve a less anxious and more meaningful life.
Thank you, Stephen. I'm going to be discussing No Time Like the Future by the well-known Michael J. Fox. Fox is an actor who's probably best known for his role as Marty McFly in the Back to the Future movie trilogy in the 1980s. He's also known, unfortunately, for his ongoing battle with Parkinson's disease. Since his diagnosis at age 29, he's been a model of both optimism and realism. He has also focused much of his resources on advocacy for other victims of Parkinson's. This most recent memoir focuses on his struggles with Parkinson's and the spinal cord surgery that led to his having to learn to walk again. He deals with the issues of hope, fear, toughness, and of being realistic.
How to Astronaut, An Insider's Guide to Leaving Planet Earth by Terry Virts. This humorous and informative guide shows readers what it's really like to be an astronaut. It covers all the highs, lows, and humors of an experience that few will ever get to know firsthand, including survival training, the art of putting on a spacesuit, the terror of a launch, how to handle weightlessness, and to what exactly does an astronaut pack for 6 months in space, plus much more. This book is perfect for any reader looking for an entertaining guide to know what it's like to travel in outer space.
A Memoir of Friendship and Physics was written by Leonard Mlodinow, and author Mlodinow and Stephen Hawking were both collaborators and friends for almost two decades. His memoir of Hawking gives us a deep personal glimpse of his friend Hawking. The book's of course about Hawking the genius, the way most of us know him, who formulated a path-breaking theory of black holes, but it's also a book about Hawking the colleague. Because of his illness, he was only able to communicate at 6 words per minute, but he still managed to inject humor into his conversations. Finally, it's about Hawking the friend, who could convey so much with a frown, a smile, or even just a raised eyebrow. He was the kind of man who, despite his overwhelming physical limitations, would make spur-of-the-moment decisions like punting on the River Cam in Cambridge. This memoir shows us our human capacity for overcoming seemingly insurmountable obstacles.
His Very Best, Jimmy Carter, A Life by Jonathan Alter. This is the first full-length biography of Jimmy Carter, the 39th President of the United States and the Nobel Prize-winning humanitarian. In this book, the author suggests that Jimmy Carter is actually the only president to have essentially have lived in three centuries. Although he was born in 1924, his early life on a farm without running water or electricity might as well have been in the 19th century. Then his presidency put him at the center of major events in the 20th century, and his efforts on conflict resolution and global health address challenges of the 21st century. In this biography, he draws on fresh archival material as well as 5 years of extensive access to Jimmy Carter and his family. And this biography provides a fresh insight into both Jimmy Carter's life and then also his presidency.
Jerry Seinfeld's Is This Anything? Is his first book in 25 years, and it features his favorite material from almost 50 years he has been in comedy. Here's Seinfeld's comment. Whenever I came up with a funny bit, whether it happened on a stage, in a conversation, or working it out on my preferred canvas, the big yellow legal pad, I kept it in one of those old school accordion folders, so I have everything I thought was worth saving from 45 years of hacking away at this for all I was worth. This is perfect if you loved Seinfeld when it first aired, or if, like me, you're getting acquainted with it for the first time on Netflix reruns.
Modern Comfort Food by Ina Garten. This is the 12th cookbook from the Popular Food Network personality. And Ida Garten knows that we could all use some comfort food sometimes, I think especially this year. So she's providing 85 new recipes to satisfy your deepest cravings. Many of these are inspired by childhood favorites, but with the volume turned way up, such as creamy tomato bisque paired with a cheddar and chutney grilled cheese sandwich, a kale and broccoli Caesar salad, and split pea soup with crispy kielbasa, plus much more. And of course, what is comfort food without dessert? So there's recipes such as black and white cookies, peach almond torte, and chocolate chip coffee ice cream sandwiches. These recipes are sure to satisfy your cravings for comfort food with a fresh and unique twist.
My next book is not probably destined to be a bestseller, but it's an example of the kind of gems you can check out free at the library. It's Stylish Succulents to Crochet by Sarah Abondio. It's a book about two of my loves, crochet and succulents, and it's her third book of amigurumi, which, as you probably know, is Japanese for small creatures. I have had a lot of success with crochet. I have killed every succulent I've ever had, so I may be finally able to have my succulents and keep them alive. And it looks like something where I could make great little Christmas gifts or birthday gifts.
The Rise, Black Cooks, and the Soul of American Food by Marcus Samuelson. This groundbreaking cookbook celebrates contemporary black cooking and recognizes black excellence in the culinary world. It features 150 recipes, many of which are inspired by top chefs, writers, and activists. Some of the recipes include chilled corn and tomato soup, crab curry with yams and mustard greens, grilled peri-peri shrimp with papaya and watermelon salad, plus much more. It also includes stories of dozens of black cooks and creators whose culture and creativity have led American cuisine forward. These dishes feature flavors tracing from the African continent to the Caribbean, all across the United States and beyond. And this book is more than just a cookbook. It is a celebration of the contributions of the past and an exploration of the chefs and recipes on the cutting edge of the future. Group: How One Therapist and a Circle of Strangers Saved My Life by Christy Tate. This memoir is a recounting of the author's 5+ years in group therapy. So she starts off struggling with both an eating disorder and suicidal thoughts, and then she signs up for group therapy on the suggestion of a friend. There she meets a therapist who slowly pushes her to confront her issues, as well as encounters fellow group members who both provide support and confrontation. This moving and witty memoir is an account of one woman's journey to find love and stability, and will empower readers to better understand their own lives.
Cary Grant, A Brilliant Disguise by Scott Eyman. In 1999, the American Film Institute named Cary Grant the second greatest male star of the golden age of Hollywood cinema, trailing only Humphrey Bogart. I grew up loving his combination of good looks and madcap comic timing in movies like The Philadelphia Story and Bringing Up Baby. I remember the day when my teenage son first discovered him in Arsenic and Old Lace. Mom, this is like the funniest movie ever. Unfortunately, there was a dark side to his life, and the author shows that Grant, handsome, well-spoken, and talented, spent most of his life and his career constructing a persona for himself. He had a persona that disguised the pain and brokenness of his childhood, scars that followed him in all of his relationships. He was born in England to a father who was a drunkard and a mother who was sent to a mental institution when he was 11. He was first told she'd gone away on a long vacation, and then at one point that she had died. It was only when he was 31 that he did find out she was still alive in the asylum. All his adult life, he struggled getting close to women. In fact, he was married 5 times and had numerous affairs. In his own words, Grant suffered, and I quote, "a sadness of spirit that affected everything I did. I always felt that my mother rejected me."
South to Freedom, Runaway Slaves to Mexico and the Road to the Civil War by Alice L. Baumgartner. This book explores a previously little-known aspect of history and examines the crucial role slaves who escaped to Mexico had in the coming of the Civil War. So I think most people are familiar with the history of slaves escaping north up into the northern United States and into Canada. But this book explores how when Mexico abolished slavery in 1837, thousands of people in the south central United States opted instead to escape slavery by crossing the southern border. This book explores why Mexico abolished slavery and how this fueled the growing divide in the United States over the issue, including what role that had to play in Texas being annexed by the United States. This book provides a revelatory new perspective on the causes of the Civil War.
My next book is She Come By It Natural, Dolly Parton and the Women Who Lived Her Songs by Sarah Smarsh. This fall we'll be treated to another gorgeous coffee table style book by Dolly Parton that collects the lyrics and stories of 175 of her best loved songs, and we will have a copy at the library. But the book we're featuring that also is going to come out at the same time looks at the women of Dolly Parton's songs, the often overlooked strong females of the working poor. These are women who might reject the term feminist, but who, like Dolly, have challenged all the stereotypes that have been assigned to them.
The Rough Guide to the USA's National Parks by Rough Guides. This stylish coffee table book is perfect for both travelers wanting to explore national parks in the United States, as well as anyone wanting to virtually travel from home. It contains detailed entries on each of the 62 national parks, including highlights, wildlife, and unique natural landscapes. It also includes over 150 high-quality photos, along with evocative descriptions that bring each park to life and showcase what makes them each so special.
My next book is The Butterfly Effect, How Kendrick Lamar Ignited the Soul of Black America by Marcus J. Moore. This is the first biography of an artist that some people consider the king of rap. Lamar's only in his early 30s, but he's already a 13-time Grammy Award winner. He's won the Pulitzer Prize for Music. He's produced and curated the soundtrack of the blockbuster movie Black Panther, and he's been named one of Time Magazine's 100 Influential People. Author Moore doesn't just focus on Lamar's success, though. He also examines what he sees as the artist's profound impact on people suffering during this time of racial oppression. And he sees Lamar's message as one of hope.
All the Young Men by Ruth Coker Burks with Kevin Carr O'Leary. This is the true story of Burke's experiences as an early AIDS activist in Hot Springs, Arkansas in the mid-1980s. So her story begins on a whim while visiting a friend in the hospital for a different illness. She notices a patient that's dying of AIDS in a quarantine room that even the nurses are hesitant to go into. Word then spreads throughout the community that she is the only person willing to help these young men, and she begins to develop friendships with others suffering from the disease. This book chronicles her efforts in the early years of the epidemic, from helping AIDS patients find food, housing, and medical care, to searching for funeral homes willing to take their bodies, while facing harassment from people in the community because of her efforts. Ultimately, her role became obsolete, both due to the negative effects of AIDS advocacy becoming big business, as well as the positive advancements made in treatments during the 1990s. Her story shows how one person's courageous compassion and activism can make positive impacts even during a difficult time.
One Life by Megan Rapinoe. You probably realize that Rapinoe is an Olympic gold medalist. She was captain of the United States women's soccer team. She's also a two-time women's World Cup champion. In her memoir, One Life, she talks not only about her athletic career, but also her highly publicized stance on equal pay for women athletes and the rights of the LGBTQ community.
So the last two books that we're going to talk about are going to be for the dog lover in your life. This is Dog's Best Friend, The Story of an Unbreakable Bond by Simon Garfield. In this book, he explores the relationship between humans and dogs, drawing on history, science, art, and personal experience. He starts out by theorizing about the early origins of the domestication of dogs and how dogs were depicted in ancient art. He then goes on to detail the different roles dogs play in modern life, from the dogs of the Soviet space program to their roles in detecting bombs and drugs, as well as the companionship they provide their human owners. It also explores the various ways humans express their love for dogs, from depictions in literature and art to following along with the author to the world's largest dog show in England. This book is a celebration of both dogs and dog lovers.
And the last book that we're going to feature in this book buzz is Dogtography. That's hard to say. Dogtography. A Knock Your Socks Off Guide to Capturing the Best Dog Photos on Earth by Kaylee Greer. The author is owner of the Boston Dog Breath Photography Studio, and she also stars in the National Geographic TV series Paparazzi, which showcases incredible dogs around the world and is dedicated to improving the lot of shelter dogs who've had a rough life. As her website states, she is fueled by the joy, whimsy, and unrelenting happiness that is so uniquely canine and is so clearly reflected in the cover of this book. As an amateur photographer and animal lover myself, I'm really looking forward to checking out this book. I love that the first chapter of the book is Speak Dog. As a cat owner, I'm fully conversant with feline moods, but I have a feeling I'm going to need to learn an entirely new language to capture the best in dogs, and I think this book is going to help. And just as I said, I am looking forward to checking out this book, and all of these books are available for you to check out either now, some of them are already in our catalog, or will be shortly.
Thanks, Cindy. And then also, as a reminder, we do have our regular nonfiction book club here at the library, the Let's Talk Dewey Book Club. That's where we choose the topic and then you choose the book. So our next virtual discussion is going to be in December. It's going to be posted on Tuesday, December the 15th at 7 p.m. And then myself and Abby is the other librarian that facilitates that book club discussion. The topic for December is going to be free choice, so any nonfiction book that you would like to read. If you have comments that you would like to share, if you'd like to share a title and comment with us and are not on our email list already, just hop onto our website, allenlibrary.org, and then find the page for the Let's Talk Dewey Book Club. You'll find both my email and then Abby's email, and just email both of us, please, and we'll be happy to give you some more information about participating and add you to our email list. So we hope you'll join us for that. Thank you again for joining us today for our nonfiction book buzz. We hope you found some new nonfiction books that you're looking forward to reading. And again, please leave us a comment and let us know what you're looking forward to reading. We'd love to hear your thoughts. So thank you again and happy reading.
Yes, thank you.